Good morning. Welcome to the Easter Sunrise service. I'm so glad you're here with us today. Thank you for getting up early to come and be a part of this with us. We really hope you enjoy today and a happy Easter. So Maya's going to come up here and start us off.
Please join me in the call to worship. Jesus Christ is risen today. The tomb could not hold him.
The grave is empty. Christ is risen.
Humanity's sin could not condemn him.
He has sin's power over us. Christ is risen.
Death could not contain him.
He conquered death for all eternity. Christ is risen.
Jesus Christ is risen today.
Christ is risen indeed.
Please join me in our opening prayer. Most merciful Father, let us be strengthened by you. Grant us that we may put full armor of God, so that we can stand against the evils of the enemy. Remind us of your victory over death. Allow our hearts to be filled with your love. Allow our hearts to be open and receive to what you are saying and doing in our lives. Fill this place with your Spirit and allow us to feel your presence. Amen.
The city does not need the sun or the moon to shine on it, for the glory of God gives it light, and the Lamb is its light. The nation will walk by its light, and the kings of the earth will bring their splendor onto it. On no day will the gates ever be shut, for there will be no night there. The glory and honor of the nations will be brought into it.
There is plenty of darkness in the world to make any of us tremble. A 5-year-old boy was critically injured when, for no reason, a man threw him over the third floor railing at the Mall of America. 4 humans and thousands of livestock were killed in Nebraska during a bomb cyclone in March. Nearly 45,000 Americans committed suicide in 2016 alone. And underneath all the darkness, we can see lies and even darker, more terrifying darkness. The Apostle Paul says, "We do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the cosmic powers over this present darkness, against the spiritual forces of evil in heavenly places, an entire system of spiritual darkness spearheaded by Satan himself influences every corner of the earth and it rages right below the surface of our everyday lives. Less than 20% of Americans attend church regularly. Roughly 70% of teens stop attending worship when they turn 18. How do we live with any hope while we struggle in all this darkness?
If we have found Jesus, we don't have to hide from the dark anymore. No matter how dark our days become, God sent his Son to give light to those who sit in darkness and in the shadow of death. His light doesn't make the darkness any less dark, it just conquers every shadow within something stronger. That means we don't need to pretend the darkness isn't dark after all. That cancer isn't really devastating to a family, that divorce doesn't really shatter everyone involved, and that abortion isn't really a decades-long genocide. That whatever darkness you're facing personally isn't really that hard or painful or scary, but we also don't need to face the darkness alone. God is light, and in him is no darkness at all. And in Christ, he has shined his light into every hidden corner of our darkness. He was not afraid of the dark, but came into our darkness. He left the safety of heaven to walk in the shadows with us, to die in these shadows so that we might leave them behind. And then he rose from the darkness to prove that the darkness had been stripped of its power in the name of Jesus.
And because this Jesus, your Jesus, conquered the darkness, you too can overcome the darkness in this world. The Apostle John writes, "Little children, you are from God and have overcome the worst in the world. For he who is in you is greater than he who is in the world." Jesus says, "In the world you will have tribulation, but take heart, I have overcome the world." Do you believe him? Even as you watch the stream of discouraging and depressing news in our nation and from around the world, even when you stare at the trials and suffering in your life, your God has overcome this world. And in his name, you have overcome this world. Everyone who has been born of God overcomes the world, and this is the victory that has overcome the world, our faith.
At this point, I'll have you guys stand up, and hopefully our next song will work this morning. So please go ahead and stand, and the words will be up on the screen.
Thank you. And I'm not sure, there we go. We'll begin, and we're going to do a little differently. We won't have the words up on the screen. This is a streamlined version of it, so I will just be doing the reading this morning. Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, you made us in your image to love and to be loved. When we turned away and our love failed, your love persisted. By the suffering, death, and resurrection of your only Son, Jesus Christ, you delivered us from sin and death and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit. On the night in which Jesus gave himself up for us, he took bread. He gave thanks to you. He then broke the bread. He gave it to his disciples and he said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When the supper was over, Jesus took the cup. Again, he gave thanks to you. He gave it to his disciples and he said, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." And so in remembrance of these, your immense acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and we offer ourselves in thanksgiving, and Lord, we do it as a holy and living sacrifice, and we do it in union with Christ's offering for us. Gracious God, we pray that you'd pour out your Holy Spirit on all of us who are gathered here as we receive the symbolic body and blood of Jesus Christ and remember the grace and redemption that has been made available to us without price. Lord, by your Spirit, make us one with Christ, make us one with each other, and make it be so until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and your holy church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. Levi, are the ushers prepared to escort people forward? Was that part of your plan? Okay, I'd like to ask the communion stewards to come up. Also let the congregation know we do have elements. If you're gluten intolerant, just let the communion stewards know. The body of Christ broken for you, and the blood of Christ shed for you. The body of Christ broken for you, and the blood of Christ shed for you. I don't know what's what, but...
Down in Joseph's tomb. desires do, and all alone.
Now that we have the computer back up and running, I'm going to ask you guys to stand up, and we're going to sing Glorious Day and In Christ Alone, and then we will have the benediction. So please stand, and the words for both of those songs will be up on the screen.
Alone, my hope is found. He is my life. light, my strength, my song, this cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are still, when striving cease. My comforter, my all in all, here in the love of Christ I stand. despised and rejected, bearing our sins, my Redeemer is here. Hands that heal nations, stretched out on a tree, and took the nails for me. Far away, rising, he justified freely forever. One day he's coming, oh glorious day, oh glorious day.
One day the grave could conceal him no longer.
Christ is risen indeed. Therefore, go in the power of the risen Christ to work, live, love, and serve. For the resurrection has changed everything. You have nothing to fear. You are never alone. Sin and death will not have the final word. You are more than the conquerors through him who loves us, who gave his life for us, and now sits at God's right hand interceding on our behalf. Go in peace, for Christ is risen.